السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. On behalf of Markaz Sahaba, the voice of Ahlus Sunnah wal Jama'ah, we present to you lesson number 2013 of our daily Nasiha and advice. Today, with the grace and mercy of Almighty Allah Jalla Wala, we focus on the 28th of Shawwal. It was on the 28th of Shawwal, the year 594 after Hijrah, corresponding to the 2nd of September 1898. And we find that the British and the Sudanese troops defeated Sudanese tribesmen and established British dominance in Sudan. So we see again that, remember, it is the government and their army that's selling out the Muslims. As you see today in the Arab countries and Muslim countries, majority of them selling out the people because they want to remain in power, and then they go bootlicking to the West and so forth. So that's exactly what we are seeing nowadays as well. Similarly, on the 28th of Shawwal, on the 1099 after Hijrah, so corresponding to the 6th of September 1688, the fort of Belgrade, which was on the southwest of Budapest, that's in Hungary, fell to the Germans after they defeated the Ottoman Empire's soldiers and Mujahideen. And the Ottoman army put up a valiant fight and resistance, so much so that more than 7,000 soldiers of the Muslims earned martyrdom. So that is what jihad is all about. You have to dice with death. Either you become a martyr or either you conquer the enemy. And the Quran Sharif speaks of this, إِحْدَى الْحُسْنَيَيْنِ. If you are victorious, you will receive the booty, the spoils of war, and so forth. And if you have passed on, then remember you are a martyr. وَلَا تَقُولُوا لِمَنْ يُقْتَلُ فِي سَبِيلِ اللَّهِ أَمْوَاتِ. Do not say regarding those people who are martyred in the path of Allah that they are dead. بَلْ أَحْيَاهُ وَلَكِنْ لَا تَشْعُرُونَ. But they are alive, but you human being, you cannot perceive and comprehend it. Yet another place in the Quran Sharif, بَلْ أَحْيَاهُ عِنْدَ رَبِّهِمْ يُرْزَقُونَ. They are alive and they are bringing sustenance from Almighty Allah Jalla Wala. فَرِحِينَ بِمَا آتَاهُمُ اللَّهُ مِنْ فَضْلِهِ. They are rejoicing the honor, the dignity given to them for the grace and mercy of Almighty Allah. وَيَسْتَبْشِرُونَ. And they want to give the glad tidings to their family members and others. بِالَّذِينَ لَمْ يَلْحَقُوا بِهِمْ. So that who have not joined them as yet. So it shows it's a win-win situation. Remember in Mishkat Sharif, Khalid bin Walid radiallahu anhu Saifullah, his letter to Rustam, إِنَّ مَيَّا قَوْمْ. With me I have such people. يُحِبُّونَ الْقِتَالَ فِي سَبِيلِ اللَّهِ. They love dicing with death in fighting the path of Allah. Kama tuhibbun al-khamr. As you love your alcohol, we translate it as you love your wine and swine. You can see today the kuffar, and said to say many Muslims also involved in all this wine and swine and drugs, and Allah forbid. For jihad, you have to have iman. Quwwat imani. Therefore, Almighty Allah Jalla wa Ala addresses us, Ya ayyuhal ladhina amanu, 89 different places. Did you ever ponder why? Because iman is the motivation, is the inspiration. It will take you to the great, great heights. Because we first place our trust in Almighty Allah, then in all the means and asbab that are available to us. The converse, the non-Muslims, Almighty Allah address them once only. Surah 66, verse number 7. Ya ayyuhal ladhina kafaru, la ta'tadirul yawm. O you non-Muslims, do not cite excuses. Innama tujzawna ma kundum ta'malun. You will be punished according to your deeds. It shows humiliation and disgrace. That is the wealth which Almighty Allah has given us and conferred upon us, the greatest wealth of Iman and Islam. May Almighty Allah protect and preserve our Iman and take us from this world with perfect Iman and Islam. Ameen, Ameen, Ya Rabbal Alameen. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.